Good morning, students. Welcome back to our digital science classes, which is provided by our school, St. Paul Senior Secondary School, as you know that. And so, students, some of you know me, and some of you don't know me because those who don't know me, I think he or she just joined recently. So, students, welcome back after a long period of summer vacation. I hope you all are well and good. Stay healthy and stay at home. So, students, as you know that we complete our periodic first syllabus in advance in the month of May, and now we starting our half yearly syllabus from today. So let's start now. So, students, our half yearly syllabus chapter starts from material, metal and non-metal. Now I tell you about what is material. Material is a mixture of substances. It can be pure, it can be impure, it can be living or non-living. Mostly it is classified on the basis of their characteristic, which is mainly physical and chemical. So, students, everyone aware about that, where we live, there are some things which are metal and something which are non-metal. If we talking about the door of a room, which is made by wood, and the handle of that door is made by iron, or it can be silver. So the difference between both of them, the door which is made by wood, it's made by non-metal. It can be said that it is a non-metal. And if you're talking about the door handle, which is made by silver, iron, or there are a lot of metal, so that is that thing is made by metal. So in our civilization where we do just develop our society and lot of things, the progress of human beings going to be civilized and linked with the discovery of metal and non-metal. Discovery with metal and non-metal. If you're talking about alloy, copper, bronze, and there are a lot of metal discovered that time. When we just develop the modern society, we live in modern society, there are a lot of development. So just this discovered by with help of metal. Okay, that era is known as iron age, because we called that era iron age because of that time just the great discovery happened in the our civilization, which is known as iron. Everyone aware about iron. So some of and today index, if you're talking about today index, property or most probably prosperity depend upon the amount of metal and non-metal, and also produce and their uses. So in our universe there are 180 metal discovered till today, and where is the 22 are non-metal and 70 are metal. Some of the common metal we commonly used our day-to-day life, like iron, silver, copper, and I'm not talking about gold because I think it's a very costly. And okay, so and some of their revenue, non-metal used as oxygen, nitrogen, and helium, carbon dioxide, and also chlorine. Okay, Now I'm talking about what is element, exact element. Then element, a pure substance that consists of only one kind of atom is called element. Now the word which I used is common is atom. The elements and material can be pure or impure. So element is a substance that consists of only one kind of atom. One kind of atom is called element. Okay. So now, what is atom? Atom is the very smallest unit of any kind of element which can't be divided into their small unit is known as atom. Now elements are said to be the basis of unit, the building blocks of substance. Metal. Now metal is divided in three parts. First one is metal. Okay, student. So first, as a chapter said us, material, metal, and non-metal. The definition of metal: the element which are hard, lustrous, malleable, ductile, and sonorous. These are all the properties. These all properties in the any kind of metal having are known as metal. What is the element which are hard, which are unbreakable, lustrous, malleable, ductility, and also sonorous, and good conductor of heat and electricity. Mean to say, easily passes the electricity from one part to the another part. And the electricity also are called metal. If we're talking about example, the example of metal are iron, copper, gold, lot of and etc. Now second one is non-metal. Easily, this is the opposite. All the opposite of the metal known as non-metal. Okay. The definition: the element which are brittle, non-lustrous, non-sonorous, non-ductile, and also the poor conductor of heat and electricity are known as non-metal. Talking about non-metal is nitrogen, sulfur, carbon, and oxygen. These are all the example of non-metal. Now I'm talking about the last category of material is metalloids. What is metalloids? Metalloids are the element which have both properties. The properties of metal and the properties of non-metal. Both the properties in some kind of material are known as metalloid. If I'm talking about the example of metalloid is boron, silicon, and arsenic. Okay. Now our next heading of this chapter is occurrence of metal and non-metal, where it is found and where it is going to be made by man or it can be made by artificially. Okay, if I'm talking about occurrence of metal and non-metal, occurrence of metal and non-metal. Okay, where is it found? Metal and non-metal. If I'm talking about in nature, metal are found or occur in both in the free as well as the combined state. The earth crust is the main source of metals. Mainly we can find the metal and non-metals from the crust of earth. Less reactive metal such as silver, gold, and platinum. If we're talking about silver, gold, and platinum are generally found in the free state or native state. We can found it a free state or native state. Mean to say free or combined state. These metals are called novel metal because it can be it will find in the free state, or we can say natural state. Some reactive metals which are react with another one are such as iron, zinc, calcium, sodium. It occur in combined state as mineral in rocks. We found it in minerals in rocks in the earth crust. Okay, almost all rocks contain minerals. All rocks contain minerals, because rocks that contain metal in profitable amount are called ore. The definition of ore you can find out and you can learn it. Almost all rocks which contain profitable amount of metal are known as ores. O-R-E-S. O-R-E-S. Ores. Okay. Profitable amount found on a rock from the earth crust are known as ores. Along with, after that, minerals ores also contain impurities called gangue. We found some impurities when find the metal which is found with the help of rock, because I told you that rocks also contain some profitable amount of metal, where the some impurities we can find, we found also from the rocks are known as gangue, G-A-N-G-U-E. Okay, in the series of process using which metal are extracted from their ore, metal extracted from their ore is called metallurgy. M-E-T-A-L-L-U-R-G-E-Y. Okay, so students, just like metal, non-metal also occur in free state. If we talk about oxygen, nitrogen, as well as in the combined state such as carbonate, silicon and phosphorus in nature, we can find it also in free state in our nature. Okay, our next heading is physical states, physical properties or physical states of metal or non-metal. Now if you're talking about physical state of metal, because the physical state of metal generally solid at room temperature. Okay, because I told you that metal are hard, lustrous, ductile, having sonorous. These are all properties so that metal having the physical state, in the physical state solid. This is a solid at the room temperature, except mercury and gallium. These two metals are not going to be solid at room temperature, which exist in the liquid form at room temperature. Everyone know that, everyone aware that, or also everyone know about that. When we go to the doctor, they just put the thermometer in and measuring the temperature of our body. Measuring the BP, blood pressure, with the help of a machine. Also, you can easily observe that both are at the room temperature but not going to be solid, because when we just put the thermometer in our mouth, also putting the just wrapping of our hand, and after pressing the balloon type, the mercury going to be up. If they are going to be solid at room temperature, the mercury is not going to be up, and told the exact number of volts or BP told. Okay, so if I'm talking about physical state of metal, generally except of mercury and gallium, all the metal are solid at the room temperature. And if I'm talking about non-metals, is exist in all three states. Non-metal exist at the three states, but they are generally solid or gas at room temperature, like example talking about hydrogen, oxygen. These are gases. Iodine, silicon, carbon and phosphorus are solid, but bromine is found in the liquid state, but they are all non-metal. Now if I'm talking about their hardness of metal and non-metal, metal generally hard, I told you that in the beginning of chapter, and hardness varies from metal to metal. Some metal are highly hard and some metal are maybe you can mold it very easily. Okay, metals such as sodium and potassium are soft. It can be easily cut with knife or you can just break it with your hands. Now, and talking about non-metal are generally soft except diamond, because diamond can't be cut with any kind of equipment. You know, everyone know about, because it is the form of carbon, which is the hardest substance ever. I know that. Okay, luster. If talking about the properties, the third properties of metal and non-metal, lusterness. Metal are luster or shiny. Many kind of metal are luster, having some shine. It means that metal have a shiny appearance. Both metal have the shiny appearance. If you carefully observe the fresh cut surface of metal, which are not before the 1 week or two week, if any fresh metal cut in front of you, the shiny part appear to us. Okay, you will find the shiny appearance, everyone. It refers to a metallic luster. The shiny appearance of metal such as gold makes them useful in making jewelry and decoration pieces. Now we're talking about the non-metals. Non-metal are non-lusters, as I told the definition earlier. Non-metal are non-lusters, dull except iodine and graphite, which are lusters. Okay. Now our second heading about the physical properties of metal and non-metal is malleability. The property which allow the metal to be hammered into the sheet is known as malleability. You can easily observe that whenever you can go to the any ironsmith shop, they just beating the any kind of metal and convert into the hard part or hard metal into the sheet is known as malleability. Okay, we can convert any hard substance, we can convert any hard metal into the sheet is known as their malleability properties. Metal are malleable. For example, aluminium metal can be hammered from thin sheet of paper, and copper can be hammered into the thin sheet, and these shows that they having the malleability properties. And if talking about the non-metal, the properties of malleability in non-metal are beating the sheet with hammer, they break into small pieces. If you're talking about the chalk, it is also a non-metal. If I beat this with a hammer or any hard substance, can this convert into the sheet? I think no. It convert into the small pieces of parts, which so that this any kind of non-metal having the properties of malleability. Okay, this property is due to which non-metal break up into hammering is called brittleness. I told and I write the definition, the brittleness. If we take a piece of carbon, say pencil lead of charcoal and hammer, the carbon article will break into the pieces. Okay, so our next topic, I will told you in another video. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.